once there was a little girl named Clara. Merry Christmas, she said as she greeted each guest. The last guest to arrive was Clara's godfather, Herr Drosselmeyer. Can you say Herr Drosselmeyer?
Herr
Drosselmeyer. Oh, all the children loved him very much because he was a toy maker and a wonderful storyteller. Clara thought he could even perform magic. Merry Christmas, Clara, he said, presenting her with a heavy package. Merry Christmas and thank you, Clara cried, lifting a large wooden nutcracker from the wrappings. He looks like a very brave soldier, she said. And so he is, Herr Drosselmeyer replied. Where's the nutcracker here? Where is it? Where is it? Just then the musicians began to play a lively tune and the grown-ups began to dance. Look, you see the sugar plum fairy and the cavalier? So pretty. Now we must depart, the prince said. But one day we will return to the land of sweets. As the two rode off in their magical sleigh, Clara felt that she was in a beautiful dream of a Christmas Eve she would never forget. Yeah. Yeah. Does anyone want to tell me their favorite part? The mice, yes, when the prince won the battle. That's awesome. Does anyone else want to share their favorite part? The dancers. That's my favorite part, too.
When she turned it back.
Yeah, that's such a special part. That's okay. Well, we're going to have a special time now where we are all going to get to dance. So if everybody could stand up. Okay, everybody standing up? Up, up, up on your feet. Okay, so we're going to start with our arms low, almost like we're holding a big giant beach ball. We're gonna have our heels together, and this is called first position. Wow, good job, everyone. That looks very good. Good. And then we're going to tendu, put our heel down, and now this is called second position. Very good. And we're going to tendu. Put our heel right on our foot. And this is called third position. Wow, those look great. And then we go tendu, heel down. And the ladies, we curtsy. Yeah, very good job, everyone.
Hi, I'm Ty Vicari, and I am here at the Barnes & Noble in Carle Place today, where they're having a book fair fundraiser for the Omen School of Ballet. And I'm with Amber, who is one of the ballerinas of the school, and she's also a volunteer that helps out with the younger children. So, hi, Amber, how are you?
Hi, I'm well, how are you, Ty?
I am doing good. So, tell me, what is going on today? I saw you doing a story with the children, and they were so super adorable in their little wooden soldier outfits. So, talk to me. Tell me what's going on here.
This is just an awesome event that we are just bringing the ballet to the community. We want to show people what we do, and it's like a great opportunity for the younger dancers to get to show what they do as well, and fundraise for the school and New York Dance Theater.
So the New York Dance Theater, what is the next performance that they are going to be having? I know with the holiday season, there must be a lot going on.
Yeah, so the next performance they're going to have is the Nutcracker. It's an awesome, awesome show. They've been putting it on for like 30 years now. I grew up performing in it. It's an honor to see it still growing and thriving and just demonstrating the artistry that's here on Long Island. and the artistry of the children on Long Island.
So you have the great gift of teaching the three-year-olds, was it?
Yeah, like the 3 to 5s. I've done classes with them, yeah.
So that must be a lot of fun because well, first off, they're probably super active.
Yeah, they're super active. They just love to run around and dance and express themselves. It's a great outlet for them. They always just enjoy everything that you throw at them, and they eat it all up, and you'd be surprised how much that they remember and that they bring to the next class, and even on stage what they're capable of. It's really awesome.
So I'm really excited because today you guys are raising funds. Do you have like a fundraising goal? I know that with every purchase, if a parent mentions that they're here for the fundraiser, portion of that sale will go towards the Omen School of Dance. So do you guys have this like, oh, we really need X amount of dollars?
Actually, I'm not aware of the X amount of dollars, but in order to put on our show, there's always a lot of supplies that will be needed. The costumes are always in need. We will be using costumes for years and years at a time, and then they'll get worn out because we're dancing in them and we're working so hard in them, and we want to make everything look as new and as fresh as possible. So we have goals for our costumes and goals for scenery.
All right, so can you show me a simple dance move or a simple ballet move? I mean, I don't know if I can do it, but, but a simple ballet move that, you know, the audience can say, wow, that was so super cool. And easy, I can do it at home.
I don't know about easy. Sure, I can. Let me think of something.
On the spot.
On the spot. There's just so many. It's like, what do you choose?
So could you, I always see like the ballerinas that they do their pose. Could you do like a...
Yes, I'll do it. Yes, okay. I got it. I got it. I'll do a nice ballerina.
There you go. I'm
sorry.
Oh, wow. And ballerinas are always super pretty. So thank you so much for letting me speak to you. And I know that there's actually a couple of performances coming up. So are you going to be performing in them?
I actually can't be performing in them this year. I'm only volunteering for this event. I'm an alumni of the school. I grew up, like I said, on the stage since I was 4 or 5 years old. I am now in school. But it's great to get to go back and watch myself and see how it's grown and evolved.
Well, then thank you so much, and good luck with today.
Thank you so much.
Hello, so I am here with some of the students from the Omen School of Dance, and this is young Avery. Say hello.
Hi.
That's Avery. And you are?
Kate.
Kate?
Galena.
Galena?
Sophia.
Sophia. All right. So, ladies, what are you going to be performing today?
We're performing the Polly Chanel dance from the second act.
And it's the second act of the...
Nutcracker.
Nutcracker. And so, what do you do exactly? Like, you train... You go to practices. How often do you practice?
Our rehearsals are once a week on Saturday, and sometimes we practice finale on Sundays.
Nice.
Okay. We have like, it's like a lot, all of our rehearsals are on the same days and the classes. So it's really like a lot of rehearsals into one day. So it sounds like not a lot, but it's really a lot.
Yeah, we're there
all day. All day on Saturday, we're there.
From like 10:45 until 6:30.
So is it a lot of fun?
Yeah, it's fun. It's really fun. I love being with all these guys. It's worthwhile.
So when did you first start? And I'm going to go to each and every one of you. When did you first start dancing ballet?
Well, I was first at the school when I was 6, so that was 6 years ago. This is going to be my 6th Nutcracker.
Oh, wow. Wow. And how about you?
I started dancing when I was about 2, but I came to this studio about 3 years ago, so this is about my third or fourth Nutcracker.
Very nice.
I was here at Mommy and Me, and then I wasn't here for a couple years, and then I came back, and this is my 5th Nutcracker.
This is my first Nutcracker at the Omen, but I've been dancing since I was about 4.
Oh my goodness. So you ladies are seasoned ballerinas. So, and you, I know that you have to prepare because you're going to be performing in a little while downstairs at the Barnes & Noble here in Carle Place. Now, what we're doing here with the young ladies and all of the ballerinas of the Omen School of Dance is that we're helping them to raise funds at Barnes & Noble in Carle Place. So if you wanted to tell someone your age, let's say they never balleted before, but they want to become a ballerina, or maybe someone younger wants to become a ballerina, what do you think is a word of advice that you would give?
You have to work really hard and always turn out your feet.
There you go. Always turn out your feet. So, all right, ladies, let's do it. Let's go. Always turn out your feet. And there you go. And so these young ladies will be downstairs in a few minutes, and I hope you guys watch them. Thank you. So I am here with Lorraine Sheff, and she is a board of director member for the New York Dance Company here. Well, exactly where are you located?
We're located. Our studios are in Commack at 60 Calvert Avenue. And our performances, though, are at Hofstra, at the John Cranford Adams Playhouse.
So now, what is the mission exactly of the nonprofit side of the organization?
The nonprofit side is to bring and educate the community in the ballet. There's a lot of people who are unaware of good ballet. They think the only place you can get good ballet is New York City, which is true. But Mr. Roman, our director, our artistic director, was a member of New York City Ballet for 22 years and danced in the Nutcracker, and had Mr. Balanchine, the founder, had originated very many roles on him. So he decided he was going to open a school, and Mr. Balanchine was still alive, and he recommended Long Island. So Mr. Roma came out to Long Island and started in a little studio above a Chinese restaurant in Green Lawn. You talk about desperate spaces, right? And we've progressed from there, and now we have 3 full-size studios and sprung floors, which is a Mr. Balanchine invented, basically, which helps the girls. It's not as rigid and it's not as hard on their feet and legs as they're dancing over the years. That's usually what will most ballerinas will get injured, because of the floor surfaces. So we've maintained Mr. Balanchine's traditions in maintaining the studios, and Mr. Omen teaches the Balanchine method, which is unique unto itself. It's a certain way of presenting the various exercises and the various steps to the girls, and it builds their strength. We are very lucky. We do not have very many major injuries with the girls because the way Mr. Owen teaches, and the other teachers in the school, they all follow the same system, same method.
So when today we're here at Barnes & Noble and we're raising funds for the organization,
right.
And what are those funds going to go towards?
They will go towards community action, bringing the ballet to the community. We do the Nutcracker, we do another performance in the spring, and we're often asked to do things like this today here at the store, and we feel that's our duty, to bring the ballet to the community. A lot of people enjoy it, needless to say. This is easy. It's easy to sell the Nutcracker.
How would a child enter into your school? Like, and is it for anyone, like let's say there's a child that may not, you know, have it financially, would they still be allowed to enter?
We'll work
school
with them. Okay. We will, yeah. All they have to do is call the studio, mm-hmm. arrange to come in and take a class.
Okay.
And if they've got background, Mr. Roman will evaluate them where they fit in our class system. And if they're newbies, they'll go into our little baby class, which I'd love to watch.
So I am so glad that you guys are doing this. And I remember watching the Nutcracker. Oh my gosh. I remember watching it on Channel 21. And
mm-hmm.
like I loved watching the ballet because there's such grace and beauty.
Every little girl's dream.
Yes, every little girl's dream to be a prima ballerina. So,
definitely.
So thank you so much.
Thank you for coming.
Well, thank you for having me. I really appreciate that. But again, this is to raise funds. And let's say someone wanted to give a donation. How would they go about giving you a donation?
They can go online to omenballet.org. And there's information on there as to how they can donate to the company.
Now, could you spell that out?
OHMANBALLET.org.
All right, so you heard it here first, guys, and gals. So if you want to donate, go to ormanballet.org and come see the Nutcracker at Hofstra. When are you guys playing?
December 15th and 16th.
Wow.
Right down the road.
Right down the road, and it's only a hop, skip, and a jump away.
Free parking.
What's better than that? This is Long Island,
right?
So thank you so much.
Thank you.
All five of my children perform in the Nutcracker some way or somehow. It's been a family experience, and it is for a lot of us at Omen that, you know, our family members become involved, and we have our parents perform in the party scene as parents. It's just an enjoyable experience to be in our Nutcracker as well as to watch our Nutcracker.
So the Nutcracker is on December 15th, and it's going to be at Hofstra. If people wanted to get tickets to the show, where would they go for those tickets?
Well, you can call our ballet school. It's 631-462-6266. Somebody can help you get tickets if you need it, or you can just go right onto our website, omenballet.org, and you can click on our site and quickly get some tickets that way as well.
So, and it's definitely a show that you want to see, and you want to say, you know what, make it a family event. Bring everybody with you, right? I mean, I remember watching on TV growing up the Nutcracker and on WLI. What is WLI? Because I'm going to ask you now. I was a kid watching this and I always wanted to dance. What would you give a parent as advice on how to bring their children into the world of ballet?
Well, I think exposing them to the ballets in whatever way you can, if you want to go online and expose them or watch a TV show. But to go to a live performance, I think would encounter an appreciation for the arts and for the ballet. And it's for boys and girls alike. There are beautiful boy dancers in the show as well. And our show is, if you don't want to go into Manhattan, our show is very close to the Lincoln Center Ballet that New York City Ballet performs. We do have two New York City Ballet guest artists who are going to be appearing in the performance, and it just makes it easy for Long Islanders to come and see a full-length performance that has many highlights that Mr. Frank Omen has added to it.
All right, so I am here with two wooden soldiers, and their names are?
Juliana
and?
Aviva.
Aviva, and so Juliana and Aviva, how long have you been dancing?
So I think I did Mommy and Me, and then 4 years ago I started actually doing ballet.
Oh wow, 4 years ago? So can I ask how old you are?
I think I was like a little after I was like turned four.
Oh my goodness, so that's awesome. And so when did you start dancing?
I started dancing when I was four, and I did a Mommy and Me class at a different school of ballet.
So do you like ballet dancing?
Huh?
Yes, and how about you?
Yeah.
And what is your favorite part of the Nutcracker? Aside from your part.
My favorite part is the opening scene where Claire and Fritz and all the children are dancing on Christmas. And everyone's having so much fun, so it makes me have fun in the dance because I'm a party scene boy too this year. So I get to dance the dance, and it makes me feel like it's actually Christmas, and I feel really happy about it.
Yes, Christmas makes us all happy, and you love to dance as well. So what's your favorite part of the Nutcracker?
Yeah, the same thing, like party scene, because also I'm a party scene girl, so I get to do it. And it's
that is really cool. So you guys are going to be in this for a while, right? You're planning on dancing until you're, what, 18, I guess? Or is this something you want to do when you grow up? Mm-hmm. So this is your dream. All right, and how about you? Do you want to be a ballet dancer when you grow up as well?
No, but I would like to try and do it as long as I can.
Absolutely, absolutely. And you guys, your costumes look so adorable. So is there something that you can do, like a move that you can do for us as a soldier? Like, what are one of your soldier moves? Like, there's a lot. Okay, so show me how a soldier would stand. A nutcracker soldier would stand.
Like, there's putting guns like this.
Okay. So I'm going to pretend this is my gun. So we hold it like this. Go ahead.
Well, also, it's like really long, so there's like tons of different moves.
So do you twirl the gun around?
No.
No. Okay, yeah, that would probably be dangerous. I'm going way, way, way beyond what you guys are doing now. So show me. Do you have like a step like that you do? Or like?
Well, do like marching.
Okay, so show me. Okay, how about the two of you come together and you show me your soldier march. Awesome. Awesome. So this is a great thing. So you guys are going to be performing. Are you doing a little performance here today, or did you do? No? So if you want to see these two cutie pies performing, you have to go to Hofstra on December 15th to the New York Ballet Company. So thank you so much for letting me interview you, and just say goodbye to the camera. Bye.
Thank you. Thank you.